बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट एन इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक, इम्पोर्टेंट एंड लेंथी टॉपिक, गैल्वानोमीटर। कैन यू डिफाइन गैल्वानोमीटर? एज यू हैव लर्न अबाउट गैल्वानोमीटर इन योर प्रीवियस क्लासेस। यस, वेरी गुड। इट इज़ एन इलेक्ट्रिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट यूज टू डिटेक्ट द पैसेज ऑफ करंट विद सूटेबल मैग्नेटिक मॉडिफिकेशन। इट इज़ चेंज इन टू एमीटर, वोल्ट मीटर एंड ओहम मीटर। एमीटर इज़ एन इलेक्ट्रिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट यूज टू मेजर करंट, वाइल वोल्ट मीटर इज यूज टू मेजर पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस एंड ओहम मीटर इज यूज टू मेजर रेजिस्टेंस इन ओहम। As we have learned in last lecture, when current is passing through a conductor in the presence of a magnetic field, the conductor feels experiences a force. Same case is here in this topic. So the working principle of this galvanometer depends upon the fact that when a conductor is placed, conductor, you know, any material through which electricity can pass easily, is placed in a magnetic field, so it will experiences a force, okay, and this force remains here experienced by the conductor as long as the current passes through that conductor. So due to this force, a torque, we have discussed in topic 14.9 about torque, the turning effect is known as torque. So due to this force, a torque acts upon the conductor if it is in the form of a coil or a loop, just like in last lecture we have discussed this diagram. If the conductor is in the form of a coil, there is a rectangular coil or a loop, okay, that this is, we can say, a rectangular coil. It has sides AD and CB and the direction of force F1 into the paper and F2 out of the paper. So these are two equal forces, equal in magnitude but opposite in direction, so they make a couple. So due to the effect of that couple of forces, the coil will rotate, okay. So the torque produced is equal to N, this is a number of turns in the coil, I is a current passing through it, B is the magnetic field in which the coil is placed, such that its plane makes an angle alpha with the direction of B. A is area of the coil and cos alpha is the angle between magnetic field B and the conductor. Due to the action of the torque, the coil rotates under the action of force, that is in the form of a couple. So tau is equal to NIBA cos alpha. As we have proved this formula in last topic, tau is equal to IBA cos alpha. Now there is addition of N. N just represent number of turns of the coil, okay. If there are not a single coil, single loop, there are number of turns of the coil, like in the form of a transformer. So that's why we have inserted an extra term N here, NIBA cos alpha, that is used to calculate torque when a number of turns are available in a given loop, okay. From this formula, there are at top 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, there are 6 terms. If any 5 are given, you can calculate 6th one. So it means from this formula you can calculate torque. If remaining 5 terms are given, you can calculate number of turns, and if rest of the terms are given, you can also calculate amount of current, magnetic field, area and angle alpha, okay. If out of these 6 any 5 terms are given, then you can calculate the 6th one. So now be attentive girls, this is the connection, this is the construction of all connections of a moving coil galvanometer. A rectangular coil C, this one is rectangular coil C, this one is suspended between a concave shaped poles, north pole and south pole. For objective, for MCQ, remember it, these two poles are concave shaped. So write on your book here, concave shape poles, okay. North pole, these are magnetic field lines direction, as magnetic field lines started from north pole and ends on south pole, okay. Again listen to me, a rectangular coil, its name is C, is suspended between the concave shape poles N and S of a U shaped magnet. this is a U shaped magnet. You can see here I have taken the diagram horizontally, okay, of a U shaped magnet, right, with the help of a fine metallic suspended wire. This one, fine metallic suspension wire, it is suspending, it is made up of metal. We can say it, this is a current leading copper wire. This is current leading, that leads current, as there connection of current, one connection, and second one is this upper connection, this one. And always remember, this rectangular coil is made of enameled copper wire, and after that this wire is, this rectangular, it is bound on a frame of non-magnetic material like D. There is a cylinder. This suspension wire F is also used as one current lead to the coil. Suspension wire F, this is used as a leading current. The other terminal of the coil is connected to loosely wound spiral E. First connection, first end of the connection of the current, second end, right? The other terminal of the coil is connected to a loosely wound, this one is loosely wound spiral E, spring like E, which serves as the second current lead. First current lead, second current lead. Okay? A soft iron cylinder D, this one. A soft iron cylinder D is placed inside of the coil to make the field radial and stronger near the coil. To make the field radial and stronger near the field, okay? Near the coil, as shown in this figure, in the form of a radial, to make the field strong, okay? When a current is passed, now current, there are two connections of current. When the current is passed through the coil, it is acted upon by a couple, okay? And as we know, when a rectangular coil is, when a coil or rectangular coil is placed in between a magnetic poles in a magnetic field, and when current pass through this coil, it takes turn, okay? It will experiences a force under the action of current and presence of field. It will take turn, it will feel a force, that due to this force it will tends to rotate. So it means if now torque is produced in this coil. Again, listen to me, it's working of this galvanometer. When a current is passed through the coil, through this coil, it is acted upon by a couple, okay? For one, there are two sides. On one side, force act upward direction, other side downward direction. Due to the action of this couple, it tends to rotate. This couple is known as deflecting couple. This is the definition of deflecting couple. Under the action of current in the presence of magnetic field, the torque tends, the coil, the rectangular coil tends to rotate, and this is known as, this couple is known as, due to which this coil rotate, is known as deflecting couple, and is given by NIBA cos alpha. And this deflecting couple is, its formula is NIBA cos alpha, as we have read in start. Deflecting couple, tau is equal to this one, NIBA cos alpha. And when the angle between magnetic field B and the conductor, this alpha angle is 0 degree, when they are parallel, it is possible when the field is radial, okay? Then the torque deflecting couple value is maximum, cos alpha, alpha is 0 and cos 0 1, deflecting couple is equal to NIBA. Cos alpha, cos 0, cos 0 gives 1, that is maximum value of cos. So deflecting couple value NIBA, that is maximum. And always remember, as the coil turns under the action of deflecting couple, the suspension wire is twisted, which gives rise to a torsional couple, is twist and untwist, okay, due to this spiral wire. Under the action of the spiral wire, in one time twisted, and it tends to untwist, okay. It is twisted, which gives to rise a torsional couple. A highlight is, it tends to untwist due to spiral wire, as like every action has a reaction. It tends to untwist the suspension and restore the coil to its original position. This couple is known as restoring couple. This one is first twisted couple is known as torsional couple. एंड व्हेन इट अनट्विस्ट इट इज नोन एज ए रीस्टोरिंग कपल विच कम ब्रिंग्स अगेन द कॉइल इन इट्स ओरिजिनल पोजिशन नोन एज रीस्टोरिंग कपल. The restoring couple of the suspension wire is always proportional to the angle of deflection theta. So that's why restoring torque is equal directly proportional to theta and is equal to c theta, where c is constant of the suspension wire is known as torsional couple and is defined as couple for untwist. Important MCQ. These two paragraphs are very very important and this complete topic is important, very very much important as a long question, right? After that, under the effect of these two couples, coil comes to rest, twist and untwist. Under the action of these two couples, the coil first twist then untwist. So under these two action, the coil comes to rest when deflecting torque is equal to restoring torque. NIBA is equal to C theta. So we will calculate the value of current. I is equal to C or BAN theta, where C or BAN are constant and I is directly proportional to theta. Okay. Thus the current passing through the coil is directly proportional to the angle of deflection. That is theta. Very very important MCQ. So today we will learn till equation 14.17. And tomorrow, inshallah, in next lecture, we will continue remaining part of this topic. These are applications of galvanometer of this topic, where the galvanometer is used. Okay. Fi amanillah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.